Hey, we're back with another video, and today we will be continuing playing the Murder of Sonic the Hedgehog. Okay, let's resume. I suppose she did wake up before us. Something could have happened. Listen, I know I'm the detective here, but all the best detectives have sidekicks. I'm gonna need your help. Let's gather clues on why Amy's acting this way, and interrogate her about it. Check out everything you can around this closet, then we'll show to Amy to uncover the full situation. Gather evidence and interrogate. Got it. I need you to do everything in your power to make sure our paying guests are well taken care of. Understood? Understood. It's got a flashback? Okay. You can count on me, Tails. I won't turn evil like your ex-flicky companion did. Happy to hear it. Now let's get searching. Tails, want me to cook any of this for you? Can we get out of here? Sure. I normally never make microwave meals. I prefer to cook, and my cast iron skillet has gone a lot of use lately. I can cook a mean iron cast iron pizza, haha. I've only had microwave lunches this week. Something's always hidden in the trash, let's check here. Sadly, it's empty. On the bright side, this is a very clean trash bin. How do I become as optimistic as this kid? We did this, look at this. Shelf with blocking our exit. It's currently not budging. Hey Russell, look closely at this. I wonder how the side of the shelf got smashed. There's nothing the shelf could have fallen into, and I'm sure that this damage wasn't here before. The train is too much upkeep. I feel like this is important. We should log it. Crap on the shelf is added to your inventory. By the wet floor sign, keeping people alert and safe. Once I slipped on some spilled juice at the grocery store, no wet floor sign at all. Luckily, Sonic was there to catch me. Wow, Sonic is really is fast, as they say. But he was going fast and also slipped on the juice. We slid into an older gentleman's shopping cart. Well, it's the thought that counts, I suppose. Now that we literally have pretty sure interrogated everything, interrogate you. What's the latest? Find any clues yet? Found a spoon. If we find two more, we can dig ourselves out. Dig ourselves out on a train? I'll keep looking. Find any clues yet? Okay. Same dialogue. What about interrogation? I don't think we have enough evidence yet. Why don't we look around a little more first? There's gotta be another way out of here. I had something. Oh! Was this a rod? The tip is broken. It looks like it have originally been attached to something. I'm not sure if it's related to our mystery, but I like spinning it around, so we'll keep it. Stick it out to your inventory. I think we found enough clues. We'll interrogate Amy and find out what really happened. What's the latest? We believe you're hiding something from us. What, you accuse me on my own birthday? How dare you? This isn't going to be easy, is it? I've been stuck in here, just like the two of you. What in the world do you think I'm hiding? Amy was awake before Tails and I were. What could she have done in that town? There was no one here other than you and Tails, and are either of you murdered? Plus Amy and I have roles that can be murderers. Some rethinking is in order. Amy was awake before Tails and I were. What could she have done in that time? Attempted to escape. I don't think you were sitting idly while Russell and I were knocked out. You attempted to escape the closet. Prove it. Show me evidence that I attempted to escape, or help me search for a way out. Do you have any evidence to prove that? Russell, let me step you through this. First, find the correct piece of evidence from your inventory. Once that has been deduced, we must form our argument to fight back. Alright, let's do it. What proved Jamie he attempted to escape the dinner car closet? Train. It's not quite convincing. Let's give it another try. Then would it have been this? Yeah, you're right. Put some damage on the shelf that's supposed to prove something. It fell over. Damage makes sense. There's no argument here. You're grasping. Okay, Tails, what now? Well, now we follow this train of thought. How does this... whatever. So now I have to explain myself. Well, you see, when I get stumped, I like to think. What would Sonic do? What would Sonic... Sonic's a force to be reckoned with. He's always running forward, collecting rings, and crushing badniks. He never loses. Like an endless runner game. I play a lot of those on my phone. Oh, sure, whatever works. Just close your eyes and think, what would Sonic do? And find your argument. Alright, let's prove. Not grasping. Let's follow the train of thought and fire a comeback. Like Sonic would do. Think. Oh. What? Oh. Sure, the shelf fell, but there's nothing around for the shelf to fall into. You're telling me on a train in this well kept that the damage was here before we arrived? Ah, we have a point though. Well, I believe someone is responsible for hitting the shelf. Tails, you have a valid point. You just said nothing was around for the shelf to fall into. What was the shelf of hit with then? This! What is that, a stick? You truly believe a stick could do this kind of damage? Think! Oh, okay. Get harder to... You get a thought, okay. You're right, a stick can't do this kind of damage to the shelf on its own. But if it's attached to something, it could, let's say, a hammer? Ack! No way! This isn't a stick at all, is it? This is actually the handle to your Pico Pico hammer. You attempted to hit the shelf out of the way, but you failed. Handle to your hammer snapped right off. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. It's as you both said, I tried to get out with my hammer, but I failed. Gave the shelf one big whack and the handle ripped right off. I figured it was no big deal and tried to hide it, but I suppose my embarrassment got the better of me. Haha, you stink, Amy. She does look genuinely sorry about the situation. Never expected your hammer to snap like that, Amy. It was one of my backups. It's a little lighter to carry around, and I didn't think I'd need it. But lucky for you, I'm a detective, and I dabble as a mechanic. Let me see both pieces of the hammer. Just tie things here, a little elbow grease there, and fixed. Tails, thank you! According to my calculation, if you hit the shelf right here, it should do the trick. Alright, stand back. There you go, the shelf completely shattered. Incredible. We did it! We're free! Great job, Amy. Let's get out of here. Can we go to the casino? Whoa! Wait, is that? It can't be. Sonic? Someone murdered my darling Sonic? Why was she smiling about that? Looks like the game's begun. I'm finding out who did this at once. Amy, wait, I want to figure out who did this too. Wait for me. What a whirlwind, I'm exhausted already. That was really convincing, Sonic. Sonic? Yeah. Body gnome. Can't move. What are you saying? I don't understand. I just need to rest. Sonic, is he actually hurt? He's not moving. Are those wounds on him genuine? My hand's on his wrist, but I don't sense a pulse. Am I doing this right? What in the world is going on? Is this the part of the murder mystery? Is this serious? Sonic! I feel myself panicking. Calm down, Russell. What do? Think! I need you to... People. Yes, I knew this. Which means they must be... Oh, these guests are incredibly renowned, which means they must be remarkably... Oops. So I leave their care to you, Russell, my favorite employee. Sure, you won't let me down on this last ride. Fa-ha-ha! Fa-ha-ha-ha! I need to catch up to Amy and Tails and get to the bottom of this, even if this is the part of the game. I just can't risk it. Keep everyone safe, Conductor. You'll see. I think it might be the Conductor, not gonna lie. Ooh, the murder of Sonic the Hedgehog. Okay. Okay. Saloon car. Okay. Whoa, look at this place. Amy, are you here? I've looked around, I don't see her. I think Amy's already gone ahead. It seems she's really excited. Did you need something from me? I mean, I just question really, how do I put this? What if Sonic is actually hurt? Ha 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 ha. He's laughing? Sonic doesn't go down easily. He's on a train full of his friends. Nothing would actually happen to him. We're just already committed to the mystery for Amy. You have nothing to worry about, I promise. Okay, plus Sonic likes to nap in a lot of strange spots. He's fine. He's making a lot of sense, but I can't shake what Sonic said to me. Is this really a part of the mystery game, or is this something deeper happening? I need more evidence to find out what's going on. Can I tag along with you? If you don't mind, is it cool if I tag along with you? Of course, sure. Now if I ever need a snack, you've got me. Haha, fair. As I said, the best detectives have sidekicks. Sidekicks, so I'm happy to have you. Ever catch me looking glum, though? Just know it's because where's my
war card?
The last guy had a work case with me, ditched our practice to join and evil Dr. Eggman, not a proper detective without baggage. This is true. You varmints. What are y'all doing in my saloon? He's trying so hard to stay in character. Knuckles, we're trying to figure out who murdered Sonic. I can see that. Emmy moseyed me. He threw and told me all of that. Enough of that. Wonder how long he kept that voice up for Amy. Wondering if you could tell us what you were up to before the murder. Anything to help us establish your alibi and... Nope, I have nothing to tell either of you. Leave me alone. It's obviously, I get agitated about something. But why would he take it out on us? I know better than to argue with Knuckles, so it seems we're on our own. And Russell, we need to figure out how what Knuckles was up to while we were all apart. Let's investigate and then interrogate. Right, let's do it. Okay, so Knuckles is right there. Maybe we won't be able to give the game Super Monkey Ball a try. Do we think it broke when the train sped up? The damage looks more caused from punches. I think that was clearly Knuckles. Who could have done that? Knuckles, he rage quit. What are you two looking at me for? Smashed arcades out to your inventory. Bounty? Decent cash reward for finding this robot. Maybe I'll keep an eye. Poor Omo Chow. I'll handle it to... I hate to see him like this. What'd they do? Medical malpractice? Interesting. Ah, the bowl of assorted nuts, the classic saloon snack. Crunch, crunch, crunch. Kind of bland. Seems like someone licked all the salt off of them. Or maybe they're just unsalted. Black arms here are really helpful. What are you doing to my hair? Fix it up a bit, that's incredible. What interesting tech. Uh-oh, should I fear my job for a little bit? How well can it microwave? So this is interesting. What is it, just a few used cups? Sure, but why are there three? Knuckles was really thirsty. Oh. This one has lipstick on it. I don't think that's lipstick. That's not Knuckles' color at all. Someone else must have been here. We should log this. Used cups added to your inventory. We found enough clues. Let's go interrogate Knuckles and find out what really happened. And I told you to leave me alone. Your hat. Oh, he's blushing! Knuckles, are you blushing? Said, leave me alone. Doesn't look like he's used to being complimented. Can you just adjust your hat a bit so we could see it better? Said, leave. Knuckles, Russell and I need to determine what you were doing during the hour the murder took place. I already told you to buzz off, or if you're not getting anything out of me. Thankfully, we don't need to say much. What happened here is pretty obvious. Is it? We have evidence, too. We do? Russell, just take a good look at our inventory. What was distracting Knuckles during the time Sonic was murdered? This. Arcade machine, ha! Makes you think I touched it. It was smashed, bro. About to die. Oh well, at home. You see, you know where you make you. You are weak. Ouch. Russell, let's follow that train of thought again, shall we? Yeah. Great. Okay, we have an idea. Good, good, good. Do this. This isn't a tough one, Knuckles. Knuckles, you clearly touched the arcade machine because... Super Monkey Ball is your favorite game. What evidence do you have that the damages are punches? What are you all staring at my hands for? Knuckles, you clearly destroyed the arcade machine, but why? I needed a punching bag and none were available to me. Just a sudden urge to punch, huh? I believe repairing the arcade machine will give us our answer. How will you? I'm on it, Russell. Drag Knuckles while I fix Super Monkey Ball. Bring it on. Think. Okay, let's do this. Okay, there we go. Arcade machine's fixed. Don't look at the scores! Quick look at the scores. I'm pulling it up now. Vector, Nuck, Toast, so it's because Vector was better than him by 1 point. Nothing, obviously. Those are something massive. Look at the top of the list. It's Vector. She's supposed to be in a library club. Picture is beginning to be painted here. You competed with a Vector to see who could get the highest score. And Vector beat you. And in frustration, you destroyed the arcade cabinet. Grr. He's punching the air in frustration. You're guessing. Where's your proof? Where's your evidence? Vector's a common name. Prove to me he was here now. Let's do this. 35? Damn. Not bad. You have nothing. Zilch, none. Now leave you two. Quick, Russell, let's try this again. Not enough rings, damn it! No, you have nothing, Zilch, not enough. I'll leave you too. Quick, Russell, let's try this again. I need more rings. What do I suck at this? You haven't. My god, bro, what do I stink at this? What? Try this again, okay? Russell's dream gear. There we go, finally, okay. Good. 41 out of 35. Okay, let's see. Idea. Now Russell, what proves Vector was here? With Knuckles. I knew you were both talking out of your body. Try this again, Russell. What else? Oh yeah, you're right. No. I thought it was strange there was more than one cup sitting next to you. Well, you're supposed to be participating in the murder mystery game waiting for Amy's birthday. You and Vector enjoyed some drinks playing arcade.
Don't tell Amy!
I think we're on the right track here. So as you say, Vector popped in at the top of the hour wanting to play the arcade machine with me. We went back and forth trying to figure the game out, but when we competed for the highest score. When he beat me, I destroyed the machine. No proof of his win. And I was trying to fix the arcade cabinet before you two came in. And honest, I didn't want to be caught. And that's my story. And alibi. And alibi. I've already told an abridged version of this to Amy. Boy, this friend group has a lot of pride issues. Well, that explains one of the used cups. But what of the cup with the lipstick mark? Rouge was in here too. It's insequential. Not worth mentioning. She searched around for something but failed, made fun of our game and left. Noxious, that one. But you offered her a drink, apparently. Listen, I don't know why she showed up and I've told you everything that happened before the train sped up. Are you not satisfied? And will you two relent? Not understanding the scenario. Vector visited to play games. His Rouge couldn't find something and left. Then Knuckles destroyed the machine. That all makes sense to me. Thank you for answering so many of our questions. Actually, that's not everything, is it, Knuckles? I want to step back to something I noticed. One more name on the score list. It doesn't make sense. Russell, can you take a look one more time? Odd name on the high score list. What is Tails talking about? Candy, Bagel, Bolton, Apple Toast? About bread. No, not that one. Not a mind reader, it's probably apple. There's a toast. Bagel? Old Tim? Names have a food theme, but this one. Who here goes by Olton? You may not know, Russell, but there's someone here that goes by the title. The Ultimate Life Form. There's really? There's someone here that goes by that? Nothing sneaks by you, does it, bud? Vector and I were struggling so much with the game, but then Shadow dropped by. So Shadow was here too. He taught us the game and was the first to get his name on the scoreboard. Vector and I fought to beat Shadow's score. They were both very annoying. So you all immediately had to compete, huh? Gave me this before he left. A key. Okay. Shadow told me to lock the door and not open it for anyone. Then he left. Then Vector was leaving. I locked the door behind him, so saw no one else after locking the door. That's the honest truth. So when Amy came through here not too long ago, did you open the door for her? I think she has some sort of key too. That's right, the conductor gave her that special birthday key. Well, I have a lot of questions. What happened in the library to cause Vector to come here? Why shadow locking doors and what was Rouge searching for? I don't know. They didn't tell me, even though I asked with that cowboy accent. You're gonna have to find him and ask them yourselves. Okay, more information than I expected to get here, but seems we can move on. As of right now, I believe your story, Knuckles. We'll only know for sure when we confirm things with Vector. Fair enough, the library's next, Carl. I'll open the lock for you. Give whoever KO'd Sonic an earful for me, Detective Tails and Butler. I get better when he wasn't talking to us. Will do, Sheriff. Come on, Russell, let's head to the library. On it. It's way more exciting than microwaving chili dogs. Russell, help coming! Ready to mosaic up to the next car? You got it, partner. Onwards. Library car. This stuff is getting heavy. I'll dump what I don't need. Everyone's favorite journalist reporter, Ian Rose, is hot on the scoop. I'm heading out. You've been fabulously helpful. Alrighty, before you go, SBO, and I wanted to give you your presents. My presents? You're both too sweet, thank you. Vector, it seems we have more guests. Amy, there you are. Hope for the birthday, girl. Aw, she knows everyone's allowed to be sassy on their birthday. The tip is just too juicy to ignore. I'll see you around. Don't worry, Sonic. I'll be the one to avenge you, and quick. But how are you gonna leave? The door's next car is locked. Oh, you doubt the birthday girl? The birthday girl has a master key. Right, the birthday girl gets the birthday key. Of course, it's a birthday privilege. I'll solve this case before anyone else. Bye! We may be hasty, but she's thorough. Now, what are you two doing? Looking mighty suspicious, I say. I'm the detective, so I can't be the murderer. And I'm a... aren't going great. Not sure if you've forgotten, but there was a murder. Well, I mean besides that. Besides murder? All my social skills. Non-existent. I'm Vector the Butcher. I'm licensed to handle raw meat. I'm Espio the Poet. Ah, Poet, a resonant message from poet to reader meant to challenge their delicate perspectives with the most rhythmic of prose. Can I hear some? Sure, Teardrops in the Spring, can you hear me sing la la la, la 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 la, dee dee? Was that it? I have more if you like. Cherry Blossoms in the Spring. I'm most satisfied for now, thanks. At least he's rhyming, I suppose. Russell and I are here to establish that both of your alibis. Can you please walk us through what happened after Amy had everyone leave the dining car? Well, sure, it's simple. We just explained this to Amy, actually. No, I want to go to this casino! I want to go to the casino! Why, but I want to go to this casino. So, we're right here. And the next one's the casino. Where Amy told me and SBO to stay. I promptly picked a book took off the shelf and made myself comfortable. Vecchio got bored, so he left to see what Knuckles was up to in the saloon car. Yep. Where was Rouge? What? We happened to see her lipstick stain on a cup at the saloon. As Rouge came over to the library car, seemingly looking for something. Then she went in to search the saloon car. She came back shortly after we heard her shout, "No way!" at the rose shirt over there. She left back to the casino car before Shadow came through and locked our door. What she found, she's obviously been on the hunt for something. After Rouge left, what is it? Shadow walked through the casino car, then entered the library car and locked the door behind him. More importantly, why was Shadow been locking doors? Shadow walked through the library car to the saloon car. Knuckles and I were playing games. He insisted on showing us up at Super Monkey Ball. So I got so engrossed by the rolling monkey action, hardly noticed when Shadow left the saloon car. I guess he walked through the library car to the casino car again, locking the door behind him. Then he returned to the lounge car where he was meant to be stationed. Vector came back. We realized Knuckles has locked the door to the saloon car. We are stuck in the library car. That's when the train sped up. We were worried about how the bookshelves falling on us, but we got through it all right. We sat trapped here until Amy arrived asking us questions. She's the one that told us someone murdered Sonic. And yeah, all of that's happened. With all these locked doors, it seems Vector and Espio couldn't have left the library car or the saloon car. Thank you both for your cooperation. We're just going to peek around and then we'll return with any questions. If you return with any meat, I'll chop it up for you. And if you'd like to be surrounded with a poem, I've got you covered too. Thanks, guys. Their alibis seem solid enough. We should still search for clues. What we're looking for is evidence that proves what they're saying is true. We need to confirm Vector's reason for leaving his post and determine if Espio was actually in the library car reading. A tall task, but we can do it. Let's get to the bottom of this, Tails. Absolutely. I think we're going to end the video right here. So yeah, let's just quickly save. Yeah. Now that we have that, I'll see you in the next one, guys. We're going to resume playing, play more games on Steam. So yeah, have a good day or night, whatever. And Gaming Corner out.